We are starting a new series, and we're going to talk about the most interesting player on every single NBA team. I want there to be some random component to it, so I'm actually going to spin a wheel, and we're going to get a team, and then we're going to talk about the most random player. It is either going to be the most interesting story off the court, on the court. It could be the best player on the team, but it doesn't always have to be. So let's see what we got. I'm going to try and put the wheel spin on the screen for you guys. We get the Mavericks. Okay, so let's talk about the Oh. I'm kind of realizing right now that you guys are probably going to be able to see this on the thumbnail and in the thing. So it's not much of a surprise, but it keeps me on my toes. So let's talk about the Mavericks. So for the Dallas Mavericks, I have to go with Kristaps Porzingis. And just as recent as last year playoffs, the Dallas Mavericks series is going so underrated. Everyone's talking about the Nuggets series when they beat the Clippers, but we forget that the Clippers almost lost in the first round. In the first game, Kristaps got ejected and it looked like he was going and like the Mavs were going to win. He had 14 points and 6 rebounds and just the first half, and be honest, him getting ejected was a horrible call and it was an undeserved gift to the Clippers. And in game 3 he had 34 points and 13 rebounds and a loss. They had no answer for him, and not only were the Clippers heavily favored and expected to win by 4, but it never looked like they had control of the series until Porzingis had to miss the last 3 games with an injury. And in his 3 games throughout, he averaged 23.7 points, 8.7 rebounds, and he shot over 52% from 3. Really quickly, if you guys enjoy daily NBA content, make sure to subscribe to the channel. It helps out a ton. We're trying to reach 500 subscribers by the end of the month. I really appreciate you. We're here every day. Back to the video. When Kristaps is healthy, there's honestly nobody that can guard him. The best you can hope for is to try and slow him down. He's tied for the second tallest player in the NBA with his teammate Bogdan Bogdanovic, and they're only behind Taco Fall. But from an athletic perspective alone, he stands alone in this group. He originally shocked the NBA world when the draft rolled around and they saw the 7'3 prospect hitting multiple 30 plus foot jump shots in a row, and he was dunking on people as well, and it coined him the nickname the Unicorn or Porzingod. Injuries have slowed down his stats recently and his minutes overall, but we forget so quickly that just a few years ago he was so dominant on the Knicks. Right before his knee injury, he was averaging 22 points, 6.6 rebounds, and shooting 39.5% from 3. That will work. Almost shooting 5 a game, too. It's hard to imagine just a few years prior, Knicks fans were booing him as he was selected 4th overall. But I mean, what can we really expect from Knicks fans? He's quickly becoming one of my favorite players to watch in the NBA. I mean, he just hits 30-foot jump shots, he can drive it, he has good handles, he protects the rim, he's high energy, high motor, he gets his team psyched up when a big play happens, and I think him being number 2 option is honestly the best thing for him. Even though he could be the best player on a lot of teams, being Luka's 1B is a championship recipe. With him only being 25 years old and Luka only 21, this could be a lethal dynamic duo for years to come. And I think the Mavericks have proven that they have great coaching and great ownership. And so don't be surprised if they start making moves next offseason to get even better. I could see them signing someone like Victor Oladipo if he doesn't re-sign with the Rockets. No matter how good Luka Doncic gets, Porzingis will always be his golden ticket to a championship, because I just really don't think Luka can do it alone. As long as these teams keep signing super teams, as long as there's teams like the Nets, the Lakers, the Clippers, the Nuggets, one person isn't going to do it alone. But that being said, Kristaps needs to stay healthy, and that's why he's the most interesting player. In today's video, we're going from the perspective of on the court, because he needs to stay healthy and he can be a top 10 player in this league. And you know he'll put in the work. We've seen this before. He put on 20 pounds of muscle in the offseason because he felt like he was getting bullied around too much. And even though in the NBA you can get away with being skinnier, he wanted to make himself that much better. So I think Kristaps is just going to continue improving and stay healthy, do a lot of rehab. I really hope he doesn't rush back from his injury. I hope he takes his time and comes back 100%, because I really think the Mavericks could make some noise. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to try and found out a way to make it more like anonymous, because I didn't want you guys to know who it was or what team it was before, so I thought the wheel would be a good idea. But I'm gonna take the Mavericks off the wheel, so next time we spin it, we're gonna get a completely different player. I'm very excited about this series. Subscribe if you enjoy daily NBA content and we just talk about basketball in general. Comment down below. I love debating. No hard feelings. This is what I love to do. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. I'll see you all tomorrow. Peace.